a national shortage of personal protective equipment, or PPE.
As engineers and scientists, we wanted to help out during this global crisis.
We're making 1,000 face shields for frontline healthcare workers. We've already delivered more than 700 of them to local hospitals.
And are working with other hospitals and manufacturers to scale up production.
The number of cases grows. There's a new warning tonight. The U.S. does not have enough coronavirus test kits to meet the current demand.
There's a national shortage of COVID-19 diagnostics. We're developing swab designs such as these to get more testing done across the United States.
We're developing new scalable high-throughput methods to test viral RNA from thousands of samples simultaneously.
We're developing a coronavirus diagnostic device based on DNA nanotechnology that could provide results with the same speed, simplicity, and low cost of a home pregnancy test.
Here at the Wyss Institute, we're working really hard to make masks that can detect coronavirus.
We're incorporating molecular sensors and artificial genetic circuits into the textiles of face masks
that could produce a visible color change in the presence of exhaled virus particles within 1 to 3 hours.
Researchers are trying to see if certain medications currently in use for other infections might be able to be repurposed.
We're using advanced computational drug development pipelines that combine machine learning with dynamic simulation to identify existing drugs that can be repurposed and to design entirely new drugs that we can then test in our preclinical coronavirus infection model.
We are using human lung-on-chips.
We're using intestinal organ-chip to study viral infection.
We're using human lymph node organ-on-chips.
And pseudo-coronaviruses to find therapeutics that will block this infection.
And to test the effectiveness of FDA-approved drugs.
As the pandemic sweeps across the world, a shortfall in treatment has sparked a global race to find a vaccine.
The ultimate protection against the coronavirus is a vaccine. To protect the people against the virus, we are developing and testing a modular immunomaterial-based vaccine.
The modular vaccine could be easily manufactured, stored lyophilized, and adapted to new viral antigens to address future epidemics.
COVID-19 crisis is unlike anything any of us have seen before, and it's required that scientists, engineers, and clinicians around the world join together to come up with solutions. It's been amazing to see what's happened at the Wyss Institute, the passion, the energy, the creativity that's been brought to bear, and we are honored to be at the forefront here trying to come up with solutions as quickly as we can.